All right, so now we're going to explore how to connect our views to demonstrate flow. We're going to look at linking views together simply and then creating links and symbols. So to link to control to another page, here I'm selecting the symbol and editing it. And then I selected the menu control, and then I just linked the menu button to the landing to the menu page. So I'm going to jump over to the menu page now, and I'm going to make the tacos link to the menu tacos view here using the link inspector. And now I'm going to select the icon and or the image and the name of the Chuck Norris chicken taco and have that go to the tacos view in the link inspector. All right, so now I'm at the tacos view and I'm going to select the modify button, have that link to the modify screen and have the order button link to the added to cart view that shows our popover up here. All right, now I'm on the modify view and the done, and I guess the cancel as well. They could both link to the back to the tacos screen. So selecting that there. And finally the order button. So we had that going to added to cart. The added to cart popover has the send to kitchen button that should go to the cart view. There it is in the inspector. And here's the cart view. Now the charge my card button should link to the pay page. And we will jump to that view. The pay button, after filling your credit card information, go to payment, should go to payment confirmation. And that's it. We're going to just kind of edit our symbol source at the end here just to make our little logo at the top, jump to our landing view. We can make the menu button go to the menu screen globally, and the cart icon can go to the cart view globally as well. So we can add links to any control in our mockup. We can even add them to symbols. We can add them to overridden instances of symbols. And once you have this all built up, you go to full screen view. You'll see that little flash of red there. That shows the link hints. In full screen view, we have a little drop down in the toolbar that lets you navigate to other mockups. You can use these history back and right icons to go back and forth. The link hints control in the settings will let you turn on that little red flash or turn it off. There's a big arrow control here if you want to use this for presentation on a big screen and you just want to point things out with a big cursor. I'll turn it off for now. And last thing we have is this markup setting. And all these have keyboard shortcuts as well. Let's hide the toolbar using T to hide the toolbar. And let's go through our flow here. And we're seeing how all these buttons are going to the appropriate views, showing the full flow through the cart and payment. So this is a great way to demonstrate or present your wireframe deck to your team. We're still using the rough, sketchy skin here, so you could also make it a little bit more polished and then use this for presenting to your clients or to use it for usability testing with your customers. So we'll talk about switching to a more polished view with the wireframe skin in the next section.